Now, our final guest has been impressing us all with his fancy footwork and dazzling displays of ice dancing recently. Week after week, he seems to be wowing the Dancing on Ice judges and trotting off home with the top scores. It was no different last weekend when his performance really was a bit of a special case. Welcome, Chris Fountain.
Hi. Hi. I feel quite...
You look quite scared.
I'm quite intimidated by the loose women.
Why are you not?
I am a little bit. It's quite, it's quite a daunting prospect.
We're just going to talk about your sex life.
It's fine, that's fine. It's all right.
Yeah, is that all right? Do you ever say no, Chris?
Sometimes. Yeah. Occasionally.
I can't
depends
believe
who's asking.
Yeah, I was going to say, if they're a minger, you do, don't you?
Oh, yeah. Yeah.
Yeah. Steady.
Listen, that suitcase thing looked a bit odd, looked a bit bizarre.
Which one?
You know, the whole thing there.
They gave me a suitcase and
so
a
you
table.
You could choose what prop you had.
I mean,
to...
there's no kind of relationship to each other at all. I mean, no.
Did you not
had
get a choice
and the cape.
In that?
No, we literally got, like, we came there on the Monday morning and went, right, go and get the props from the cupboard thing. And we were like, all right. And I originally thought we just had the suitcase because there was a suitcase on top of a table, so I brought it out. And he goes, no, go back and get the table. I was like, oh, my God. But, no, like, it's, we didn't really have any kind of relationship between the props. Like, there was a hat and a cane, which is kind of,
yeah,
like...
Yeah, which was...
And the brolly was tied into the song. It was like, don't let it rain on my parade. And we just had this suitcase. It was actually full of wood. They put like a big block of wood so it didn't kind of collapse. So it was
Are
really
you sure
heavy.
You just didn't go to the canteen?
they probably ran out of props and went, what have we got in here? Throw that on, paint it red. I've got red all over my
hands.
Are
you having fun doing it?
I'm having loads of fun doing it. I mean, I didn't think at the start it'd be as much hard work as it is, but literally every day we got like at least 2 hours training. And obviously, because I'm working up at Hollyoaks as well, so it's like two jobs, and then I'm training at night time, and Mum's doing all my cooking and my washing and everything.
Because people have said, some people did say that maybe you had a bit of an advantage and a head start because you had been an ice hockey player. Yeah. But you said that the discipline is so different.
It was literally when I kind of found out I was doing Dancing on Ice, I thought, oh, I'd be all right at this. I used to play ice hockey. Literally, they put me on the figure skates. Different. I couldn't stand up. I just kept falling flat on my face every time because of the toe picks. So I mean. Obviously, I had a tiny advantage because I'd already knew how to
probably
skate.
Probably balance and things.
I had a bit of balance, but...
a lack of fear of falling, I suppose, because you used to fall.
But I think, anyway, I'm only 20. I'm not really bothered if I fall over anyway. I'll be all right.
Listen, we had Suzanne on the show a bit earlier this week.
Ankle,
and
she
did ask us to sort of stick our legs out and make you trip up.
Yeah.
Oh,
yeah.
Was there part of
you that was a little bit excited when she screamed in agony and broke her ankle?
Not at all. I mean, that's awful.
It's not evil like you, Denise Wells.
That's not very nice. But no, literally, because... We all understand what each other's going through every week. I mean, like, I know just how hard Gareth and Suzanne and Zara are all training. And for them to fall or for them to not be able to compete, if it was me, I know I'd be absolutely devastated. So, like, no one's really like that with each other.
You do, obviously, you want to win, though, don't you?
I'd love to win, but I just want to get to the final so I can do the flying. It looks like they do, like, it's like pantomime, they tighten wires on you, and you're skating, and then you just go.
You have to get to the final because you're just.
To.
I mean, the pressure, I think, is probably the greatest on you because every week, because we're all saying now, oh my God, he's. I mean, I wait with bated breath for you to come out every week because you've been brilliant, but that must be a terrible pressure.
I'm trying to, like, deter away from the pressure because I think if I think about, oh, Gareth's doing that, and Suzanne's doing that, and Zara's doing that, then I'll kind of forget why I'm there, and like I'll be focusing too much on trying to beat everybody. Mm. So literally, I'm not going to get to do this show again, so I'm just going out there every week, and I'm just trying to do the best that I can do and just enjoy it.
Do you think that now that you're such an all-round, talented performer, is because you played my son in Where the Heart Is?
Possibly. I think possibly. It was a while ago. I remember my mum rang me. It was 2002.
2002, yeah. So you were how
14.
Old?
14.
And I was still bathing you in that.
Yeah. But, I mean, Lindy, your mum. She's brilliant. Yeah. Is she coming down and watching you every week?
Literally, my mum's got like an army. There's like Team Fountain. You can see them in the audience. They've all got like a wash of white t-shirts.
With
it's
the
like,
posters.
It's like my mum and my grandma, my granddad and my uncle, and all my friends come down. And we all got the t-shirts. My mum's like, she's like, he's in charge of it. You sit there, you sit there. Make sure you don't clap. Because when I did the Axel like last week, my coach, because like all day I'd not been landing, it was a horrible, horrible day. And my coach said to my mum, he was like, when he comes down here, don't start screaming because you'll put him off. So I was like, right, everyone, when he comes here, don't talk, don't be quiet, everyone be quiet. But yeah, he's all right.
She's lovely because she's so proud of you, isn't she?
I know.
And you're not gonna. You're not gonna leave Hollyoaks. You're about to sign again. Is that right?
I'm signing until March 2009.
Fantastic.
And I'm also doing the Dance on Ice tour.
Are you?
So originally it was kind of up in the air whether I was going to be able to do it or not, obviously because I'm working. But I'm going to get the Fridays off work and I'll be doing the Friday, Saturday, Sunday shows.
Oh, it's nice that they've been so supportive, isn't it?
I'm just thinking I'm going to be absolutely shattered.
What's this about you padding your... Sorry, Jackie, I'll just ask about padding his trousers. What's about...
as you would, Denise, I wasn't going to ask that.
No, I don't... Right, basically, it's not natural for a man to wear a G-string. I don't think, anyway. But because the trousers are so tight, they could, if they kind of sit, you'd be able to see, like, the meat and vegetables.
And what's wrong with that?
Well, I don't know, but maybe for some people that might be embarrassing. I wouldn't really mind that much.
Do you like the clothes? Some of the men have not been very keen on the gear.
I think Dancing on Ice is all part of the glitz and glamour, so all the costumes kind of make the show. I mean, if we went out dressed like this, it wouldn't be worth watching. So I've just kind of embraced the costumes and just kind of going with it.
Well, he looks pretty good, doesn't he?
Yes! Yes.
We'll be watching with bated breath the next time. Thanks so much for
Thank
coming on.
Much.
Chris Fountain,
Cheers.
Everybody. Yeah.